Hello everyone and welcome to my channel, Advice to Think Twice. My name is Monica and I'm here with your daily advice for December 14th, 2016. And if you're new to my channel, this is a general reading looking at the energies that surround us at this time and what we need to know about these energies in order to be able to use them for our highest good. And so I always say that since we're looking at energies, these will play out in different ways for different people. And that's why I encourage everyone to keep an open mind and take away the message of the reading and then apply it to your own situation if you feel that it speaks to that. So thank you for joining me and let's just have a look at what is coming up for us today. So it looks like something that was suspended or postponed or delayed or just stopped, put aside to be revisited is getting picked back up, okay? Something that was suspended is now starting again or is revisited, okay? And it's, we have the opportunity today to complete whatever this is, okay? So again, for some of us, it's gonna talk about our jobs or our relationships or our health or our spirituality, our own projects, whatever the case may be, okay? We're looking at the energy behind it all. So the first card that we have representing the influence of the past on our current situation is the Hanging Man or the Hangman. So with the Hangman, you can see, you know, this is talking about something being up in the air, something being suspended, experiencing delays with something or putting something aside to be revisited at a later date. The Hanging Man could be a card of that says we needed more information, we needed enlightenment. Maybe we got to a point and then we just got stuck. We just could not see the way forward, or maybe the way forward was out of our hands. Maybe we depended on other people or other people's input to move forward with that particular situation. And so we did our part and then it just got left up in the air. Again, for those of us, this was something that we postponed or put aside because we needed more information, we needed to study more, we needed to train better, we needed additional training or additional guidance, information, knowledge, and so on. For others, we just needed additional resources, okay? We needed more money, we needed more time, we needed more whatever in order to move forward with the situation. We did not have these resources at the time, and so whatever we were working on got postponed. Or again, just paused, okay? And we are getting close to Mercury retrograde, and I don't know about you, but I've already started to experience it. Mercury retrograde never really got to me, so to speak. I could rarely figure out that was Mercury retrograde based on what was happening in my life. But this one and the previous retrograde was quite interesting. So it could be that the energy is moving in that direction, and so we are already starting to revisit things, to rethink things, okay? Could be something like that. The energy of today is the Nine of Cups. It's our wish card. It's our yes answer. So for some of us, if we needed an approval, if we needed someone to okay, to give us the green light, if we needed someone to say, yes, I can help you with that, yes, I can give you the money, yes, you're gonna get the money, yes, you're gonna get the time, the energy, whatever, then it's definitely coming today, okay, with the Nine of Cups. This is our wish card and a direct yes answer. So I feel that whatever was suspended, especially if we needed outside input, outside help, it's definitely coming today, okay? This is also kind of the final piece of the puzzle. So if we needed additional information, knowledge, resources, the Nine of Cups says we will find this today, okay? Or we will have that moment of clarity, that aha moment where everything that we have studied and researched comes together to give us our answer, to give us our way forward, okay? To proceed with this plan, situation, project that we had to suspend in the past, okay? Whatever the basic meaning is, whatever we were waiting on, whatever was up in the air and was suspended, now comes full circle today with the Nine of Cups. Okay, this is a card of completion, and it's happy completion at that. It talks about plenty, it talks about abundance, it talks about a wish coming true for us that makes us really, really happy. All right? And as a result, we have a new beginning. We're moving into the energy of the Ace of Coins. So we are completing this, whatever this is with the Hangman that got suspended. We are completing it. We've made sense of it. We've ended it happily, finished it successfully. As a result, we have the Ace of Coins. We have a brand new beginning that is very, very stable, that has wonderful long-term potential. The Ace of Coins is something that we start in our lives. It's a seed that if we nurture it properly, it's guaranteed abundance, okay? And I always say abundance means different things to different people. For some of us, abundance is money. For others, it's good health. For others, it's wonderful loving relationships or harmonious relationships with friends and family, success in work, recognition, whatever the case may be. The Eight of Pentacles, if nurtured properly, guarantees abundance, okay? So it's a beautiful new beginning that we're moving towards. Creating new things that are long-lasting, that are supposed to bring in stability, that will bring in stability for the long run, okay? And these cards can, you know, they can manifest in a lot of different ways, which is why I always say just take the message of the reading and not necessarily just the examples I give, because it can be more than that, okay? It could be that after a time of searching with the Hanging Man for a job, you get a job offer today and then you got this new way of making money. It could be just like that. Or in love, if you have been taking yourself out of the game, isolating yourself because you're waiting for someone to come to you or to come back to you, then today you could meet that person, or you could have a reunion with that person and then start fresh, okay? Or start a relationship, or start the next phase of the relationship, or move in together, or whatever the case may be. Starting your own business. Maybe you did not have your own the resources that you needed at the time, or the knowledge, or something was lacking, something was missing. Today, it comes full circle. You have that completion, and then moving into the future, you can have that new beginning where you have your business, you've established your business, you're starting to work, you're starting to have clients or contracts and so on. And it's a really, really reliable, long-lasting way of making money, okay? So it could be anything. It could be in health, where, you know, you were uncertain, things were up in the air, you didn't have all the information, you didn't know what was going on. It could have been a time of recovery that you're coming out of today. You get the good news that you're okay, you get the clean bill of health, okay? Or the okay from the doctor to go ahead and do whatever you want to do. And then you have a new way of living. With the Ace of Pentacles, you're more grounded, you're more aware of what's going on in your body, you feel rejuvenated, and you've got big plans for the future, okay? It could be something like that. Our guidance card is Cyan. Build your confidence, the number is 35. So 35 adds up to an 8. An 8 is a card of abundance, of success, okay? It is movement, it is rebirth, regeneration, so it would make sense. It's also reevaluation, so it would make sense with our cards here, okay? Absolutely. And definitely a card of accomplishment, so it supports the energy of the tarot cards. And build your confidence is, it talks about renewed confidence. So maybe we kind of lost our way when we were unable to complete this task, project, situation the first time we tried. Maybe our confidence was wavering, our faith in ourselves was wavering. Build your confidence says, don't give up, don't lose faith, be confident with this, believe in yourself, and move forward fearlessly, okay? Communication may be important today with this blue, well, cyan color. Communication may be important, so it could be news that the Nine of Cups brings you, absolutely, or it could be successful conversations or successful interviews, successful interactions of any kind, okay, in whichever area of life applies. Communication is key in bringing in this happy completion and then this new beginning in your life, okay? So communicate with confidence, focus on success and accomplishment, envision success and accomplishment, and it will come to you that much more quicker, that much more quickly, you know what I mean? So it's a really beautiful message for today. I'm really looking forward to the day to see how this manifests for me and for everyone, and I look forward to your comments letting me know how these energies are playing out for you and what you're focused on. But it should be a really beautiful day. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope the reading helps you in some way. Thank you so much for all your support. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for watching my videos, for liking them, for sharing them. Thank you so much for commenting. I love your comments. I read every single one. I don't always have the time to get back to everyone, but I always read every single comment, and I do answer to that comment in my own head and hope that you get the positive energy that comes from that. Yes, but I love your comments. I love connecting with everyone. And, you know, that's it. Remember that there's a New Year special, okay, if you're interested in that. The link to it is in the description box below. It's a 20% discount on yearly readings and 6-month forecasts. And I thought, you know, it would be a good idea for everyone who wants to have a look ahead and see what the year has to bring them. And of course, the raffle still open till the 15th. So if you want to take part, go ahead and check it out. Now would be a good time. I really hope that we all have a fabulous day. Thank you again for all your support, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Have a great day and take care.